In this section, you will learn about the different connection devices used with oxygen. Always remember to wash your hands before setting up or changing out your child's cannula, simple mask, extension tubing, or inline adapter. Pediatric Home Service has a variety of nasal cannulas, from very small to adult sizes. Your Pediatric Home Service clinician will determine the size needed for your child. A nasal cannula allows oxygen to flow out of the curved prongs that are placed inside the nostrils of your child. When placing a cannula, make sure the prongs face downward. Proper placement will help prevent the inside of the nose from getting red or sore. To hold the cannula in place, tender grips or medical tape can be used on a clean face. Change the tender grips or medical tape when they no longer keep the tubing in place. Another option for older children is to position the tubing over the ears and use the plastic slide to secure the tubing. Never loop the tubing over the back of your child's head. Your child's safety and comfort is important. Always make sure your child cannot trip, fall, or become tangled in their tubing. From time to time, check your child's cannula. Make sure it is placed correctly and that the tubing is not kinked, tangled, or twisted. Running the tubing inside a shirt, down a pant leg, or taping it to your child's clothing can help. To prevent infection, wipe down your child's cannula with a clean, damp cloth. Pay special attention to the nose prongs. Remove any nose secretions, drippings, mucus that might prevent oxygen flow. Each week or when needed, replace your child's cannula and discard the used one. To allow more freedom of movement, extension tubing may be attached to a cannula using a specially designed plastic connector. Always make sure the extension tubing is secured to prevent trip or fall hazards. Replace extension tubing once a month to help prevent infection. Discard the used tubing. Pediatric Home Service has a variety of simple masks from very small to adult sizes. Typically, simple masks are used when an oxygen flow of 5 liters per minute or higher is needed. Your doctor and Pediatric Home Service clinician will determine the size of mask needed. If your child comes home with a mask that is different from the one in this video, talk with your Pediatric Home Service clinician to make sure your child has the right one for home care. When placing the simple mask over your child's mouth and nose, make sure the elastic strap fits around the head. Gently squeeze the metal bar to fit the mask more snugly. To help prevent infection, clean your child's simple mask every day with one of the infection control methods recommended by Pediatric Home Service. Your child can use a simple mask until it shows signs of wear, when the elastic band wears out or the plastic becomes cracked. To allow more freedom of movement, extension tubing can be attached to a simple mask with a specially designed plastic connector. If your child uses a ventilator, bilevel or CPAP, or heated humidifier with their oxygen, a specially designed adapter may be used inline to connect the oxygen to these machines. To help prevent infection, this inline adapter needs to be cleaned weekly or during routine tubing circuitry changes. Clean the adapter with one of the recommended infection control methods. Replace this inline adapter when it becomes worn or cracked.